Good morning to all. So here I am standing before you with the next set of your 3 marks question in number system. One set yesterday I shared with you. So if any difficulties are there, you let me know. I am giving you the idea of solving these, and wherever the answers are possible, I am mentioning you need to check the answer, and I am sharing the hints to solve these questions. Like here today, the first question I have taken, insert two rational numbers and two irrational numbers between under root 2 and under root 3. So you know under root 2 and under root 3 are both the prime numbers in third forms, that's why are the irrational numbers. So you just know the definition. Whenever you are answering these questions, infinite numbers are lying between under root 2 and under root 3, maybe rational, maybe irrational. But what is the definition of rational and irrational? Like if you go for this 1.4 something it is coming, 1.732 something it is coming. In those numbers, your rational is what? Either terminating, you can mention any terminating number between those two, or non-terminating but reoccurring, that also you can pick. So feel free to mention the numbers when infinite possibilities are there, and similarly irrational. Now just try to recall the definition of irrational. What is that? That is non-terminating, non-reoccurring. So between that range, you need to write the numbers in such a way that you can show non-reoccurring and your non-terminating, and towards the end you have to put dot 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 dots there. So such question can be there either in 2 marks or 3 marks, but 2 numbers are asked, so maybe the part of your section C. So be careful about that, and don't think that one particular answer will be there. Infinite answers are possible, so you are welcome with your own answer for the same. Second question today I am asking you, yesterday like under root 5 you have to put on the number line, so today it is under root 5.6. So you know the procedure that was taught to you, take any line and then you have to draw this 5.6 the length, then you have to extend it by 1 unit and then find a bisector of that, then you have to draw the semicircle and perpendicular you need to draw. Procedure, all the steps you need to recall and follow the procedure, and exactly 5.6, and better explanation is there in your NCERT also, how and why we are getting exact 5.6 under root on that number line. So in section C I explained that in detail, even the proof was also shared and discussed, so please follow that. Then exponent somewhere is also the parts of today. 3 next questions I have added from the exponents chapter point of view. So this is 1 3/5 and power 4 8/5, power minus 12, 32/5, power 6. So you have to apply the laws of exponents. 5 laws are there. So better is like here it is 8, here it is 32. You try to get the prime factors always in case of exponents to apply the law. That will be more convenient way to you. And like 3 raised to the power 4 upon 5 raised to the power 4. Here it will be 2 raised to the power 3, means you take the reciprocal of this first and then make it positive. 5 upon 8 raised to the power 5 raised to the power 12 will be there. 2 raised to the power 3 and 12 power, that will make it 2 raised to the power 36. Here it is 2 raised to the power 5, so 2 raised to the power 5 into 6 will make it 2 raised to the power 30, and then 5 raised to the power 6. Then you are getting finally either in terms of 3 or 2 or 5. And then feel free to apply the first law of your exponents when bases are same. In case of multiplication, powers will be added, or in case of division, powers will be subtracted, and that will be a very convenient way to get the answer. Finally, whatever the number is left, that you can multiply and can have the solution. So answer I have given. Please check whether you are getting the answer or not. Similarly, next again is, here it is 3. Here it is 3. It is a prime number. But this is not a prime number. So take the prime number. Prime factors of 3 are 3 into 3. 3 square. So when 3 square I will be writing 3 is equal to 2. It will make it 2x minus 4. Then bases are same. Again you add the powers. Again the base is 3, then subtract x from that. So you see x will go off somewhere and you are left with 1 upon 9, which is the answer for this question. Next is, sometimes you are finding such questions difficult. This is a question I have added today, a kind of high order thinking question where you need to apply some out of the box thinking to get the solution of such problem. So what you have to do is,
Here ABC is equal to 1. Means wherever it is given, so try to make best use of this information to get the solution. So this is the question, and you need to find the value of this. Here it is 1 upon 1 plus A plus B minus 1, 1 plus B plus C minus 1, 1 plus C plus A minus 1. With this information, key idea I'm sharing with you. Sometime we are directly going to take the LCM. But in such questions, my gentleman advice to you is, use this to equate the denominator of all these three terms. Like first, okay, first leave it as it is. Now you just give a second thought, how I have to convert this denominator to equal, write it equal to 1 plus A plus B minus 1. Now you see, if it is B minus 1 I need, here it is 1. If I multiply it by B minus 1, so I have to divide by B minus 1 in denominator also and in numerator also. So it will become B raised to the power minus 1, and B raised to the power minus 1 into 1 will make it B raised to the power minus 1. Then you see the other ones. What happens to that? When you will multiply B minus 1 with B raised to, it will become what? 0, and 0 exponent is always equal to 1. So 1 automatically will be there. When you will multiply C minus 1 with B minus 1, what happens? It will be equal to 1 upon BC. Then make use of this. So 1 upon BC directly you can replace, that this will be equal to what? A. So where I will write BC, I will shift to this side. So A is equal to 1 upon BC. So 1 upon BC I will be writing equal to A. So it will become equal to A. Then you see your denominators of this and this will be same. Similarly, you can make it also same. Then take the LCM, denominator and numerators, and I think the result will be equal to 1. You apply in that way and let me know. If any difficulties there, I will give you the complete solution of the same. Just I am sharing the hints because this is the practice part. You have to apply the knowledge whatever you have gained. And if any difficulty, feel free to share your comments with me. Till then, have a nice time. Thank you.